Hello and welcome. My name is John Dickinson, and in this tutorial, we're going to take a look at how I created this title graphic, which was inspired by the trailer for Thor, Love and Thunder. So go ahead, download the project file, and let's get started. Let's start by recreating the text in Title Studio, and we'll do that step by step. And then I'll walk you through how I used a combination of Continuum and Sapphire effects to create the final composite. So I'm here in After Effects. If you've downloaded the project file, just open that up and double-click the Start Composition. Next, we'll create a new solid, Command or Control Y. We'll name this Title Studio, and just make sure that's black and comp size, and click OK. Come up to the Effect and Presets panel and type in Title, and there's Title Studio. It's going to hit Enter to apply that. And in the Effect Controls panel, we'll turn off Use Comp Lights, and we'll click Launch UI to launch the Title Studio interface. Okay, so inside here, first thing we'll do is delete the Boris effects text, because we're going to use an EPS file. So come over and click on Add New Media, and choose EPS file. Now we're going to use an EPS that I created in Illustrator. I actually looked for the font for Love and Thunder that was used in the trailer, but it appears that's actually custom text. So what I ended up doing was just tracing it in Illustrator and saving that as an EPS file. So this is the one we're going to use. So click Open, and there we go. So next, let's add some extrusion to that. So come down to this little gray box here, change track shape, and choose extrusion. All right, come up to the extrusion tab, and we'll create an extrusion of 10. Just like that. And for the bevel type, we're going to create a custom one. So click Custom. Down here, select Custom Bevel. Select the pen tool. Then just click once and click again and drag. Just keeping the mouse button held down. That just drags out the Bezier handles. And then just click once more. There we go. There's our custom bevel. I'm just using the mouse wheel to roll in there. So that's looking good. Now, some of the letters are actually joined, and that's how the Illustrator path was created. But other letters that aren't supposed to be joined are actually a little too close. So what we need to do is contract it. You can see this, particularly the N and the D, is a bit of a problem. So what we'll do is just select loveandthunder.eps, and we'll set edge contract to 1.2. And there's still a tiny bit more, but that's pretty good. Okay, so next we want to apply some materials. And we want a different material for the front, the extrusion, and the bevel. And we still have loveandthunder.eps selected. So under the Material tab, let's set Apply Material to 3. And that gives us a front, extrusion, and bevel material. But for EPS files, there's one more step, and that is to click on EPS and choose Spline Object. And this will allow us to place different materials on each of these faces. So we'll start with the front material. Click on Shader Color, and under the material attributes, set Type to Texture. You can see down here it says V1. So we'll click Change Track Media, and we'll choose Image File. In the Downloads, in the PS folder, you'll find this file here, Thor Horizon. This is just a gradient I created in Photoshop. Double-click that. That places that on the front of the text. It's a little too large, so we'll click on the Texture Modifier tab, and we'll change Y Scale to 25. And now that fits perfectly. Let's twirl that up, and we'll twirl down the extrusion. Click on Shader Color. And for this, we're going to use a noise material. So we'll come up again and choose Texture. Once again, click on V1. And choose Procedural. And you can see noise has been applied to the extrusion. And before we customize the noise, I just want to set up the lighting. So come up to Toggle Split View and choose Dual Horizontal. Now the left side is selected. You can see there's a yellow box around it. So we'll choose Left View. This is going to make it a little easier to set up. Just going to select my arrow tool. And if you hold down the space bar and left mouse button, you can just pan that view. select the top track, click on the Lights tab. Light 1 is already selected, so let's just click on this box here. When it turns yellow, we'll just drag this, and we're going to move it just about here and above this center line. In the render view, we'll grab it and we'll just center it, and we'll just move it down a bit like that. So it's sitting above and in front of the text. Once again, come over to the Lights tab and we'll activate Light 2. Click to select it. Now this is the one we want to use to light the noise. So we'll take that one and we'll put it underneath the text like that. Maybe just move it down a little bit. And we'll grab that, once again center it, and just put it about there. Probably just move it down again. Okay, so now with the left view selected, come up and choose World. Like that. I'm using a mouse, so I'm going to roll my mouse wheel in just to zoom. And I'm going to hold down the Shift and the Space bar, and then left click, and just rotate that view. Now I've got a really good view of the noise. Let go of the Shift key, then the Space bar. Just be careful, because Space bar actually activates play. And now we can customize the noise. So we'll come down and twirl open texture and select channel. And there's our noise settings. So let's change the type first to Voronoi. We'll change octaves to 2. And for color 1, we'll choose 188, 40, and 45. And these are just settings I chose based on the trailer. 112 for color 2, and 70, and 200. Come down to global scale, change that to 200. And for scale X, we'll choose 40, press tab, 60 for Y, and tab again, 50 for Z. Finally, come down to brightness, and we'll change brightness to minus 40, and contrast to 100. And I thought that those settings got that pretty close to what I saw in the trailer. Okay, so that's the front and the extrusion done. The bevel's super simple. Just twirl open bevel, click on shader. We can leave it set to color, but we need to see our material styles. So if you can't see the material styles tab, come up to window and choose material styles. In material styles, just choose color white variations and double click 01 white. And that's applied that white color to the bevel. That's all we have to do inside Title Studio, so we'll click on Timeline and click Apply. Okay, looking good. So now let's come over and choose Use Comp Camera. And we'll create a new camera by coming up to Layer and choosing New Camera. I want to use a 20mm preset, so a nice wide-angle lens. Click OK. Hit the P key, and we'll change the Y value to 720. Now the camera is slightly below the text, looking up at it. That's nice because it reveals this extrusion at the bottom. And finally, we'll add a few keyframes. So we'll click the stopwatch and we'll set Z to minus 4000 just to push that back. Come forward to about 6 frames and we'll change that to minus 1100. That zooms right in. Come to about 2 seconds. And we'll change that to minus 10, 15. Right click on that keyframe and choose Keyframe Assistant, Easy Ease. Hit the N key just to set the work area and preview. So now we get that nice zoom in, and then between the second and third keyframe, we get that nice ease to a stop. Okay, so that's the text done. So now let's open the finish comp and take a look at the composite setup. For the lightning effect, I use Sapphire UltraZap. So I'm just going to solo layer 6 and let's take a look. First thing is just to deselect UltraZap, and there you can see there's the Love and Thunder text. Now I actually copied and pasted the masks across from Illustrator. I'll show you what I mean. Over here in Illustrator, I just selected the text and copy. And I'll just quickly create a new solid just to demonstrate this and paste. There you go. All the masks, if I hit M, are all listed there underneath the solid. So that's exactly what I did. And you can see the masks right here. Now, before we turn that back on, I just want to mention one thing. I've actually made this UltraZap layer 3D, and I just want to come down to Title Studio. You can see we have Use Transformations turned on, and under Transformations, I've actually set Position Z to 0.5. Watch what happens if I make this 0. Got to turn this on, of course. By having the default setting of 0, the Title Studio text is actually a little bit in front of the 3D text in After Effects. And that's because the extrusion in Title Studio pushes that front face forward. So by setting position Z to 0.5, it just slips that back into registration. And it's really important, of course, that they line up because we want the UltraZap to animate around the edges of the 3D text. Okay, so I'll just hide that for a moment, come back to UltraZap and turn that on. Now for this UltraZap look, let me just do a quick preview. It's very quick. I've actually created a brand new preset for Sapphire version 2022.5. And if you have that installed, you can click on Load Preset. And inside the preset browser, you can see it listed just down here, Loving Thunder. And in a moment, we're going to be using Loving Thunder Residual as well. So these can be used either individually or combined to create the look that I've created for Love and Thunder. And we've included them as presets in the 2022.5 version. I'm just going to cancel that. Now to get the UltraZap to follow the After Effects paths, the Follow Selection option is set to All Paths. And that makes UltraZap use all of the paths that were imported from Illustrator. Now, notice how UltraZap is being wiped on and wiped off. That's being done using this layer here, UZReveal01. This is just a simple solid with a mask applied. And you can see that's wiping across and revealing the text. So in the UltraZap layer, what I did was set Matte From Layer to UZReveal01. So if we turn that off again, you can see how that's working. And you can see the two mask keyframes just here. Now for the second UltraZap layer, this is the UltraZap residual preset. So once again, using UltraZap AE path mode and also all paths. And this too uses a matte. But this one uses UltraZap Reveal 02. I'll just turn that one on. And this wipes the UltraZap on, but it doesn't wipe it off. I'm not actually wiping the bolts off here. What I'm doing is using bolt length. So I'm animating bolt length. Just hide the masks here. You can see the bolts are revealed and they're animating around the masks. And when they hit the bolt length keyframes, that animates down to 0. So we get this effect. And I call that residual because they're the bolts that are kind of left behind after the main UltraZap has been wiped through the text. If we look at both of those together, we get that effect. So that's the UltraZap setup. For the background, I use Sapphire Night Sky. Let me just solo that. Night sky is definitely the easiest way I know of to add a realistic starry night sky. And I think I've just used the default settings here. Above that, I have the energy layer. And this was created using a combination of different effects. I've got set matte, sapphire effect, a couple of BCC curl effects, BCC vector blur dissolve, and set matte. And of course, having the Boris effects suite gives you access to both Sapphire and Continuum, so you have the best of both worlds. Let's walk through this. Just turn off Night Sky and just make sure we can see the transparency grid. So first of all, I've used the Set Matte effect and I've taken the alpha channel and I've taken the matte from the UltraZap layer. Because remember, the UltraZap layer is using the masks that we imported from Illustrator. And I'm using the text as the base because I only wanted this energy effect to be, you know, around the text. I could have used a solid and then just masked that out, but it made more sense to use the text itself as the object that the energy was emanating from. Now beneath that, I have Sapphire effect, and this is a combination of different effects. So let's go in and take a look at that by clicking on Edit Effect. And if you've never used Sapphire Builder before, S-Effect gives you access to the Sapphire Effect Builder, and this allows you to create custom effects and presets using Sapphire effects. So I've just stacked a whole bunch of different effects in here to create the look that I wanted. It's going to come up to 100%. And I have Preview Selected Node turned on. So if we come to the top node and click, you can see the controls over here. And I've just added a nice big soft blur to that. Beneath that, we have Sapphire Texture Flux. This adds a little bit of sort of liquid-like animation to it. Beneath that, we have Sapphire Distort, and that adds a nice distortion effect. Now, I am using Sapphire Shape as a matte, so that's ported into the matte port, just so that the distortion doesn't go too far away from the actual text. So just keeping that in place. And beneath that, we have the Sapphire Tritone. So that combination of effects gave me a pretty good base for the energy effect that I was looking for. But I did want to give it a slightly more liquid-like appearance. So for that, I used one of my favorite Continuum distortion effects, which is BCC Curl. So if we turn that on, what I've done here is I've actually increased distortion amplitude and curl size quite a lot. So that gives some quite big curls, but I also wanted some tighter curls as well. So I just duplicated the effect, and let me just turn off checkerbox. You can see I've decreased curl size. We bring that right down. You can see I can get some really nice tight curls. Very nice. Now, beneath that, I've used BCC Vector Blur Dissolve, and this effect actually gives it more of a stringy, sort of vapor-like appearance, which is what I wanted. And finally, I've used a second set matte effect, and that's using the UZ Reveal 02 layer. So you take matte from layer UZ Reveal 02. So that makes the energy effect wipe on when the UltraZap wipes on. So that looks pretty good. You can see it gives it kind of a plasma-like appearance. It looks really nice and organic. Now, to finish the look, I've used Sapphire Ultra Glow just on an adjustment layer. And you can see I've set the color to this bright blue just by sampling a blue from the text. Don't want to go too far with this, otherwise the whites blow out too much. And above that, just Sapphire Color Fuse using the M Heavy Film Color preset just to give it kind of a retro feel. You can see it just knocks back that black a little bit and gives it that overall retro feel. Okay, so here's the final look again. Be sure to leave a comment if you have any thoughts or questions or you want some more detail. For those of you who haven't yet tried Sapphire or Continuum, you can learn more and download a demo version at boriseffects.com.